The Bold and the Beautiful Star News. Dennis Richards, Shauna Fulton, has a nasty legal dispute with the former owner. A Bold and Beautiful spoiler learns that the Real Housewife of Beverly Hills star and alumnus Dennis Richards, Shauna Fulton, is going to court, but this time has nothing to do with her predecessor, Charlie Sheen. Erin Phipers, the actress's former owner and fiancé at the time, said that the couple ransacked their rental property and are filing fraud and compensation lawsuits. Not only did Richards refuse to spend a penny, but he also despised the owners, accusing them of leaking his personal information in the evidence accompanying the lawsuit. The 50-year-old mother of three children demanded unlimited compensation for her pain and suffering. Richards and Phipers rented a property in Calabasas shortly before their wedding in July 2018, which was the focus of the case. In 2020, the owner filed a lawsuit claiming that the house was destroyed and Richards and his family left the house in need of repairs. During the seven-month lease, the defendant littered houses and landscapes, causing losses of more than $100,000, the lawsuit states. Also accused Richards of violating the leasing rules, stating that he has agreed to properly use, operate and protect the property, keep it clean and hygienic, and ensure the safety of everyone. Property damage caused by tenants or pets. The owners claim that they only allow two pot-bellied pigs and three dogs to be kept on the property, but they claim that in addition to what is allowed in the lease, there are more than six cats and dogs. Richards and Phipers deny all allegations of misconduct and stated that they will not pay a penny of the $103,000 claimed. The couple claimed that when they initially rented the house to family members and then moved by themselves, the house was in a mess. Denying the owner's guilt, claiming that the value of the property had fallen by $400,000. A source said that the case emerged after the owners, all lawyers, had difficulty selling the houses on the property. Across the street is an apartment building. Richard said it was necessary to repair the house that would have prevented the house from devaluing. She and her husband urged that the fraud should be rejected due to insufficient evidence. Richards and Fiber stated that they were not allowed to conduct their own inspections or to be present when the homeowner inspected the property. To make matters worse, Richards stated on the invoice submitted by the owner that the cost of the project had been paid twice, and the actual cost of the so-called repairs that she said she was not responsible for was approximately $32,445, not $100,000. Judge set the hearing date for this case as of December 6th.